Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2012 supernatural horror film called, The Apparition. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The movie begins with the introduction of the Charles experiment. This experiment happened in 1973 when a group of paranormal psychologists conducted this activity to summon their colleague, Charles Reimer. A portrait of Charles Reimer is lying in the middle of a table. A group of people is sitting around the photograph, hands lying flat, surrounding the picture as if doing a ritual to summon the deceased colleague. Suddenly, the table starts shaking. The people who call his soul are happy with the results of their activity. A curly-haired guy wearing his glasses, Patrick, and his friend, Greg, are pushing a trolley containing wires and luggage as if to sneak out the materials from God knows where. Carrying the trolley downstairs, Greg and Patrick bring it to a dark-looking laboratory. On the other hand, a woman, Lydia, checks the temperature in one of her experiments, while her other friend captures every moment that she is doing her work. Wondering where her colleagues are, the videographer, Ben, then captures the arrival of Patrick and Greg, successfully bringing the materials they need for their little experiment. Rummaging through their things, Greg, Lydia, and Ben assemble the things they need to proceed to their little activity. Opening the luggage-like things from the trolley, a tiny machine appears. Pressing through the machinery button, it lights up, a symbolism of its life. Further setup happens, plugging cords and wires, positioning the camera, and data showing from the laptop. A few more setup, and it's done, sitting around a table, preparing to do something big. Patrick explains the first day of their activity from the camera screen, their version of the Charles experiment. Patrick further explains the difference of their innovative experiment from the original, targeting to manifest the spirits from the real world. Kelly brings out a 3D version of a man, an object representing Charles from their upcoming experiment. Ben argues that if this experiment is a success, it will prove the existence of supernatural entities. Ben focuses the camera on Lydia's face as Greg and Patrick concentrate their attention on the figure representation of Charles. Greg discusses that 500 amps will change during the experiment, making their quantity as if they are 500 people doing the same thing. Setting their eyes on the figure, a sharp sound enveloping the area gives off a strange vibe. When a sudden bang, and a shaking off the table startles them, Lydia complains that Greg has kicked the table. He answers back with complete honesty that he did not. Seconds later, the table moves on its own. Greg panics with the sudden movement, Patrick calms him down. The creaking of metallic objects is heard. Fear evident in their eyes, they choose to continue. Patrick picks up the 3D object, fixing it in a standing position. Then Ben's shaky hands continue to capture the experiment when suddenly, a loud bang freaks them out. The camera setup falls, breaking of a glass lens crashes on the floor. Flashes of light envelop some parts of the laboratories. When the 3D object breaks, they see nothing, darkness covering their eyes. Screams of agony. Gasps of grief. When a vital energy force slurps Lydia off the wall, Ben, Greg, and Patrick cannot do anything. Just fading shouts of her name are left. Kelly, Ben's girlfriend, is shopping through the grocery store. As Ben pushes the shopping cart, Kelly chooses the products. When Kelly sees a cactus plant in a small pot, she consults Ben if she could buy it. He agrees. Arriving at the counter, Kelly sees a tent being displayed. She offers Ben camping, he only complains. When Kelly walks out on him, shaking his head, he picks up the nearest box of tents before paying. As Kelly drives through the expressway, Ben asks him about her childhood dream about living in Palmdale. Kelly explains that she loves the exclusivity of the place, abandoned neighborhoods, vacant strip malls, and surrounded by an empty desert. When a phone ringing interrupts their talk, Ben only ignores the person calling, a colleague, to his work. Arriving at the Dulce Crest, Kelly halts when she passes by her neighbor's house. She chats with the father, Mike, and his daughter, Maggie. Mike warns Kelly and Ben about their dog, Pepper, who is entirely free to roam around their neighborhood. Bidding their goodbye, Kelly continues to drive on their home. Kelly is talking to her mom over the phone. Ben, on the other hand, is searching from the boxes on the floor. Complaining that he cannot find his thing, Kelly's mom hears his rants. Ben then boasts that they are a good tenant on Kelly's parents' house investment when Kelly notices the strange changes on the cactus, suddenly it's dead. Kelly and Ben are playing video games, challenging each other to see who is the dominant player. Finishing their game, Ben and Kelly go to the kitchen, fetching a beer to drink. Ben notices that traces of something that is burnt is found within the kitchen counter, bringing a spray of liquid and paper towels to clean the mess. Unexpectedly, the dirt did not come off quickly, making him rub it harshly to remove it. Cuddling on one of the sofas in the living room, Kelly wakes up with a disturbing cold wind. Grabbing the nearest blanket, she covers her body when she sees the front door open. Immediately shaking Ben to wake him up, he is a bit disoriented about what is happening. Ben walks to the door, Kelly follows behind him, closing it quickly, making sure it's now locked. As Ben faces the opposite direction, he notices that the plants are swaying back and forth with the swoosh of the wind. Upon realization, the other door is also open. Walking outside, he roams his eyes within the dark area of their place. Seeing nothing, just trees and pure darkness, he enters the house and closes the door, securing the knob that is locked. Assuring Kelly that everything will be fine, he promises her to check the area's vicinity. Kelly brings their clothes from a laundry basket, she wakes Ben from his deep slumber. A little lip locking is not so bad, they had a bonding before anything else. However, when Ben decides to brush his teeth, Kelly fixes their clothes on the cabinet. Picking the folded tees and shorts, strange moving from the cabinet happens. Almost dropping the clothes on the floor, Kelly sees the round markings from the carpeted floor, thinking something weird is up. Arriving at their front house, Kelly witnesses Ben's installation of new CCTV cameras. Thinking that it is a good idea, she compliments him with this initiation of him. Chilling at their mini garden, Pepper, Maggie's dog, arrives at their house. Ben and Kelly follow the animal that goes straight inside their home. Upon searching, they see the dog near the laundry room, sitting as if Pepper sees someone. Growling, Pepper slowly lies on her tummy, barely breathing. Wondering what could have gone wrong with Pepper, Kelly picks her up, planning to ask for help. Kelly is checking the place where Pepper died. As Ben arrives, she calls him to tell him that the linoleum is cracked. Removing the linoleum from the floor, weird dark spots are hiding beneath it. Ben decides to check what's underneath the kitchen floor. As if he is in an army's training, he ducks and crawls below the house with his flashlight. Moving until Ben reaches his destination, he discovers the molds growing. Deceiving Kelly that he calls a worker who deals with molds, Ben sneaks through his messages. Kelly enters the bathroom, removing every piece of her cloth. Naked, she pulls the shower button and submerges into the running water. Running her fingertips with soap in her entire body, Kelly cleans herself. As she puts it back to the soap tray, mold starts to crawl within its surface, and the white soap turns black. Finishing her quick shower, she decides to leave the bathroom. Behind the shower curtains, shadows of a man-like figure appear. Ben is checking Patrick's messages. From his confession, he tells Ben that their second trial of the Charles experiment has failed. Patrick warns Ben that he is in danger, sending a video clip that contains the coverage of their failed experiment. Patrick explains the machines they will be using. Four participants will take over the experiment, collecting their brainwaves, and transferring them to the altered psychomantium or apparition chamber. The energy that will be collected will help them summon the entity that they are looking for, caging the entity through the psychomantium. Moments later, Patrick confesses that the activity is unsuccessful, releasing an unknown entity. Kelly enters her walk-in closet. Stares of anxiety are visible in her eyes, panicking to call out Ben. He immediately attends to Kelly's needs, checking what is bothering her from her closet. Upon witnessing the messy clothes hanging, hangers are broken, Ben kneels to check what's behind the fabrics. Seeing that there are scratches on the wall, he looks at Kelly, standing near the door. Shockingly, the light behind Kelly blinks. Sensing that there might be an intruder, Ben grabs his baseball bat. Dragging Kelly with him, they go downstairs to check. Booming sounds of objects dropping, Kelly walks outside to leave. Ben and Kelly choose to stay in a tent. Kelly insinuates that something haunted is happening with their house. In denial of the situation, Ben throws off the idea. While Ben is guarding Kelly, who is sleeping, a falling object disturbs him. Deciding to check the parameters, Ben leaves Kelly. Suddenly, the CCTV camera falls off the wall. If an entity targets Kelly, it goes inside the tent. Seconds later, the camera glitches. Kelly leaves for work as Ben decides to check their house. Ben sees molds growing from the kitchen ceiling, picking a stick to pop it open, a particular object falls off. Selecting the thing from the floor resembles the 3D object Lydia had brought when they did the Charles experiment. Cleaning his mess, he gets the residues outside to throw. Kelly brings a new dog to Mike and Maggie's house, a replacement for Pepper. Kelly asks Mike if he notices weird happenings, molds, lights going off, and doors opening unknowingly. Kelly decides to leave when she's done with her plan. Maggie bangs her car window, telling her that the house has killed her dog. Confused with Maggie's word, Kelly searches through Ben's things. Seeing unusual luggage, Kelly decides to search for answers. She considers the 3D figure and a scanner-like tool that can detect a person or a sculpture. When Kelly further rummages in Ben's things, she sees a photograph of Ben and Lydia. Curiosity eating her system, she looks for more. Kelly discovers the clip of the recorded Charles experiment done by Ben and his friends. Upon realization, Lydia is a victim of this experiment. Perhaps, Ben will only bring her on dangerous grounds. Moments later, Ben arrives, seeing that Kelly has already watched the video. With her growing rage, she confronts Ben and asks him to leave her parents' house. Kelly picks the detector when she feels funny, the lights turn off. Moving the sensor on her surroundings, an approaching figure is near her. Shouting to save her life, Ben catches her, calming her down. They decide to check in a hotel room, as the house is no longer a safe place to stay. Ben is stuck on the hotel room ceiling. From above, he can see his body sleeping on the sofa. Kelly, on the other hand, is sleeping on the bed. When a sudden force tries to manipulate the blanket, it crawls on Kelly's body as if covering her fully. Suddenly, the blanket tightens around her, almost choking her to death. Kelly wakes up when she feels strangled. Screaming on the top of her lungs, Ben wakes up from his reverie. Attending to Kelly, who needs some help, he tries tearing the blanket to save her. When he successfully helped her, he gave her a hug of assurance, telling her she was now safe. Ben and Kelly meet with Patrick. Patrick explains that the entity they summoned before wants to feed on humans. It will manipulate humans the way they perceive things. The rift between the entity's world and of humans widened when they did their second trial. Patrick discusses that they can do something to stop the entity. By putting the transmitters, it tries to manifest, playing the recorded EEG emissions from their previous experiments will help them feed the energy into their systems. Ben, Patrick, and Kelly distribute the transmitters where the entity first manifests its presence. Patrick instructs them to open every appliance they have so that the transmitter can locate the entity. Patrick then clarifies that the reverse usage of EEG and the linkage of the two recordings will serve as the key to lock the rift. Kelly brings a transmitter to the laundry room. Upon opening, a jolt of movement catches her attention. Running for her life, she slams the door to go outside, immediately grabbing a hammer and nails. Coming back from the laundry area, she smacks a pin through a hammer to lock the entity inside. Turning her back from the door, she finds herself locked inside the laundry room. Hitting the door with her palms, she shouts Ben's name to call for help. Looking behind her, a pair of hands dramatically appears as if struggling to go out. A pale, long, curly-haired woman comes out, staring at Kelly. She slowly crawls in her direction. Screaming for her life, Kelly calls Ben one more time. Ben and Patrick hear the desperate cries of help, immediately responding to save her. Patrick gives directions towards his house, a safe room that Ben and Kelly can use in an emergency. Ben and Kelly throw the garbage in the bin outside, leaving Patrick inside. When the door behind Patrick opens, a sudden force slurps him inside the darkroom. The couple decides to go inside, realizing that Patrick is gone, they go straight to the car to escape. Ben and Kelly go to Patrick's house. Upon arrival, Patrick's voice explaining his theory about the entity welcomed them. Patrick reveals various entities and evil spirits, the supernatural world is part of the natural world that we live. As Ben and Kelly browse along with the amenities inside Patrick's house, they find the metallic cage-like room, entering it all at once. Ben suddenly feels weird, as if something is disturbing his head. Sitting, Ben tries to collect himself. The lights turned off, darkness enveloped them. The light goes back, and Kelly notices that Ben is gone. Unfortunately, the light turns off once more. Kelly leaves the metallic cage, opening the door, Ben is there, almost lifeless. As she couldn't believe her eyes, she ran outside. With her flashlight on, she escaped through the woods. The movie ends with Kelly absent-mindedly walking through an empty parking lot. Going inside the market where she and Ben shop, she walks until she arrives in the tent section. Crawling her way inside a tent that caught her attention, sitting and reminiscing the floods of memories in her mind. Hopeless with her situation, someone from behind her, choking and slowly covering her mouth. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.